great tournament.
Cowboy!
ESPN, hey now.
Perfect setting, perfect situation for a national tournament. Leaving LA, I liked our chances, and I think everything became a little bit more positive. The closer we got to Minnesota, I felt more confident in the kids. I would never go 2,000 miles if I didn't think we had a legitimate chance to win it. We've always wanted to play the best. I think that's one of our goals. If nothing else, I always wanted to have a team that we could compete against the best in the country, and I think we proved that. So our team, by winning the Southern Pacific Division of the AAU, automatically qualified for the national championships in Burnsville, Minnesota. And compete for 2 weeks, double headers and triple headers every day to determine who is the best 12 and under team in this country.
Nice job.
Good job, guys.
Nice job.
Way to go, guys.
The coaching staff we had for the Mid-Valley Yellow Jackets was a real great bunch of guys to work for. We had Miguel Blanco, who's my first base coach. We had infamous Mike Lopez. And our last coach was Randy Linkmeyer, who handled the pitching staff. The way this coaching staff worked, when we would call a practice, pretty much knew what our jobs were gonna be. We had certain stations that each one of us wanted to work at and monitor the kids, keep an update, talk amongst ourselves on who's feeling good, who's working out well, and basically keep the spirits up and try to exude a positive attitude at all times. And I think with these guys, we were able to accomplish that.
Attaboy, good job, let's pick him up.
Yeah. We're gonna take it all.
Real good, real good. This team's ready. They're just hitting the cover off the ball. All those wiffle balls are solid. See the little holes in them? They put them in. I knew we were lacking a little bit of preparation. Obviously, another month would have done as well. But, you know, it comes to a time where you just got to turn them loose, put them on the field, and I think we got a savvy bunch of kids. And what you lack on field instruction, sometimes the kids, and I felt that these kids were going to be able to take it over. The kids went in there, they went hog wild, and I could tell right off the get-go they were going to have fun regardless of how it turned out. And when you think about it from a 12-year-old standpoint, that's what it's all about. You want to be able to take them, you want to remember the games and the fields and everything, but you want to remember the trip more than anything that we had a lot of fun on. Our team on registration day was the first time we'd been able to see them all in their brand new uniforms. I must admit, they were a fine-looking group of young men. We went down to the high school, which we were instructed to go to register the team, and actually happened to be the first ones that were there. Right away, the kids were able to start trading pins and get to know the other teams that were in a tournament.
Registration day, and actually the entire first day of the tournament, we've tried to build sort of a carnival atmosphere. The intent there is to make it look big, make it look organized, which it is. The intent is to get the kids to mix and mingle. Yes, this is a national baseball tournament. It's a baseball competition. But the reality is that there's only one team going to walk away with the gold. And we want the kids to remember how much fun they had here, even if they lose out. And it's important to me that their experience when they come here, it has to be special. If it's not, we fail.
Kids from all over will come with pins, and part of what they do is they start this trading of pins. These are like the golden items, but they immediately start trading because they want to see how many pins they can get from all across the country, from all the different teams. They trade like it's $1 million each one, you know, and each one is much more special, and that's when they really start to learn how to barter back and forth.
That for just that one. Okay, I'll give you both of these.
Andy,
the I already got that one.
I'll give you both of these little clipping ones.
For what?
For that one.
For
you have more than all the kids.
Yes. I'm doing this for my son. This is an accumulation of Cooperstown. Last year at AAU, 11-year-old national championship in Disney. We have more at home, but this is the collection he likes to show off.
My whole goal here is to have a great beginning, because if you start off poorly, it's going to probably stay that way. If you can start off with everybody having a good time, making new friends, et cetera, you know, that works out and hopefully is sort of the flavor for the rest of the tournament.
Please bring in the teams.
The opening ceremonies was quite a kick, getting all the teams together. Marching around was a proud moment. To see yourself as one of the teams that qualified across the country to be out there and amongst these young men was a proud moment for me, because I thought the kids worked really hard to earn that spot. Even though this may have been something I've always wanted to do, you never lose focus over who it's for. And I could see the kids were maybe an inch or two taller and standing up a little straighter. And. They're proud. They're proud from who they were and where they came from.
I welcome you to Minnesota. Over the next 7 days, we're going to play 186 ball games. We've got 46 teams from 26 or 27 different states. We're looking for a great tournament. This one hopefully will be the best one that we've ever had.
Skills competition is probably the bigger deal for the kids, you know. That keeps them involved once again, and it forces them to mix and mingle, because they're standing right next to two other players that are in the bunting contest or the home run hitting contest or what have you.
We had a lot of fun with it. We waited on, I think, our most successful competition was the bunting, where Carlos Lopez, Garrett Hovatt, and Aaron Mizak represented us real well. We had in the outfield accuracy Danny Linkmeyer. We had Jock Williamson. And then we had a couple in the home run derby, Miguel Blanco and Eddie Morfin. Combined, those guys can hit it about 1,200 feet.
This year, the last home run hitting contestant stepped in the box at 920, so we were down about 923.
Hovatt has played a bend check. Introduce you to our lineup.
The Mid Valley Yellow Jackets. Logan, woo! Scott, woo! Carlos Lopez, Fabian Williamson. Number 37, Miguel Blanco. Number 3, Matt Dominguez. Number 33, Danny Linkmeyer. Number 22, Sean Edniston. Number 25, Eddie Morfin. Number 43, Jacob Hovis. Number 30, Garrett Hovatter. Number 23, Aaron Mizak. And number 24, Jack Williamson.
that's a tough team to announce.
Way to go, Yellow Jackets, way to go!
Attaboy! Way to go, way to go!
I could tell you by the first game that we're going to be in for a battle on in every game. Miguel Blanco pitched a beautiful six-inning complete game. We knew that we were in the right spot because we knew we were up against the best pitchers and the best teams in the country. They were, everybody came to play. There was no giving up, no backing up. The game wasn't over until the last out was recorded. We were leading 1-0 in the bottom of the sixth with two outs. We had a bloop double hit against us, and then a ground ball hit to the gap in left center that they were able to score two runs and beat us in the bottom of the last inning. I knew at the time that they won the game at the bottom of the last inning. It was very important for us to keep the kids up. Brush it off as quickly as you can and get into the next game. Knowing that that was the only game we had to play that day, and so we had to be able to get up and play again a doubleheader the next day. So what we were able to do was practice wiffle balls that night, get up early in preparation and batting practice in the morning, worked on the basic fundamentals the next morning, and came out and pitch the gym. Fabian came in, gave us five good innings. Pitched two flawless innings. We came up and scored a run in the top of the seventh and held them in one 7-6 in seven innings.
Loving the game of baseball is something that you have inside of you. These kids at this age in this country, they have so many things to do. When I was their age, baseball was what I had to do. We had no Nintendo, TV has two channels, movies had one movie a month. So baseball was what we did for fun. We play stickball, we play with a tennis ball, we play with a rag ball, we play with any kind of ball we could find. These kids, I understand, they have a lot of other options that they can look into. So it's hard to develop love for something that is not the only thing you do. Just like a wife, you can only love one wife. You cannot love three wives. Well, maybe in Utah, but you know, not in California. So the team still needs to find the love for the game. If they find the love for the game, we will do well, and then we move forward into better things in the game of baseball.
These people that are maintaining the fields on a daily basis, dragging and chalking and what have you, and working through the rain. These people are professionals. They do this. This is all they do all summer long. The park and rec directors, Steve Michaud in Lakeville and Gary Harker here in Burnsville, and the mayors and the city councils, they've really gotten behind this and they said, if we're going to do this, we're going to do it right and we're going to support it. So that's why the fields are actually in pristine condition. I don't know what else we could do.
The maintenance on these fields in between games, they make them look like a brand new ball field every single day. So there's a lot of effort from our park maintenance department. But we put all of our efforts into this tournament for the whole week till it's finished.
I think we do a very good job with this tournament, and we're pleased that we get 26 to 28 states that are represented at this tournament this year from Hawaii, California, North Carolina, South Carolina. We like people to come and visit our community because this is a great place to be in the summer.
First base, first base, second base.
These guys right here for
they
battled
you
all day.
You guys are the bomb.
This game right here put us in the final. I don't care how many other teams are involved. So long as we're there, baby. So we're there.
Yeah. We're going there, baby.
We're talking on. We got hats. $2 for $10. Or $2 for $10, $1 for $5.
How about a pin and a hat?
Pin and a hat would cost you $10. You want two?
It takes 60 volunteers an hour to run the tournament. We have 10 fields going usually at all times, about 60 volunteers in aggregate between Burnsville and Lakeville, and then I'll have anywhere from 6 to 10 staff present at all times.
But there are several people in this community that they will actually take a week's vacation and spend the whole week down here. There are retired people who look forward to this. They come down, they spend 14 hours a day here.
If we had to pay everybody that worked at this AAU tournament in Burnsville and Lakeville, I mean, there's no way we could afford to put it on. So volunteerism, although they're getting harder to come by, is very, very important. I think we as parents have a responsibility to volunteer and help our kids' programs out to make it better for our kids and make it better for the next kids that are coming.
This is the final 12. We come through this morning, then we're in the final 8. So we do, without question, have our work cut out for us.
Who are you pitching today, Randy?
We're going to go with Matt Dominguez. He's going to get us through this, get us into the top 8. We know he can do it. He's ready.
Oh, that sucks. Could you believe how hard it was raining coming in?
Ooh, man, double high-speed turbo wipers. Both teams battled extremely hard against each other. We matched up extremely well. We had excellent pitching. They had excellent pitching. Going into the last inning of the Bo Sox game, with two outs already being recorded, you knew the runner was going to be going on contact. And they hit a pop fly down the line in right field that dropped about 18 inches fair. Even though our fielders made a gallant effort to get it, the runner was going on contact. It hit the ground, took a bounce, and before we could get the ball relayed into home, he had scored. After the game, obviously there was a lot of disappointment within the team. But one thing we tried to make clear to them, that they had at all times played with heart, played with determination. They gave it everything they had. They left it all on the field. And sometimes the bounce just doesn't go your way. Nothing to hang your head about. When you look at it, it's sometimes the game of baseball is not, it can't be kind to both sides.
I mean, there's something about youth athletics. Winning is very important, but it's also important dealing with losses. You know, I think that's one of the things that we get from athletics is the ability to deal with defeat. And we need that as life goes on, because both you and I know we're gonna get defeated in life, whether it's a golf match, whether it's applying for a job and you don't get it. And we need to know how to handle that. And I think athletics does just an excellent job in teaching that.
I was still proud of the way the kids, they were able to shake it right off. And then from that point on, we were able to try out the lakes in Minnesota.
I want fishing!
real fun to see these kids, a lot of them for the first time, hook a fish. Put a fishing pole in about six hands at a time. And the fishing was excellent. They were able to catch anywhere from what we call bluegill, they call sunfish, to bigmouth bass, to catfish. About every cast they made, they brought in a fish. You can't ask for more better entertainment than that.
You know, John Stein has to be the nicest man that I have ever met. I think every parent looks at John Stein and knows that no matter what he does, he loves their kids, and he's looking for the best for their kids, and he suffers. It hurts him greatly when he's not able to give these kids what the kids want and what the parents want.
He's wonderful. He makes each kid, I think, feel really good and special. There's not too many people like that, and he's got a tremendous amount of patience, and he's willing to give everything, you know, for our kids, not just his own, for all of our kids. So I think that's pretty special.
Saw Twins and the Kansas City Royals play in the Metrodome. We all went down with our uniforms on, flying our yellow and taking up a whole section and right down the left field line by the foul pole. The kids were able to get some autographs by players on the field. They put our name on the tote board, which was an honor for us. It's nice to know that they charge the same in Minnesota for a hot dog and a Coke as they do in California, so they ain't got nothing on us.
This tournament began last Saturday with 46 teams, and now we're down to the final two teams who will be playing for the 2001 Division I National Championship.
Well, we came back to watch a championship game between the San Diego Stars and the St. Petersburg Stingers. And quite honestly, we all looked at those teams knowing that we very well could and should be in the finals. I think when the kids saw that, they know that they had the talent to compete with any one of them. And I thought that we matched up real good with the champion. It would have been fun to give them a try. But in order to have that honor and that pleasure, you got to get up through the brackets.
An unbelievable four-peat, the San Diego Stars.
For the last 5 years, I have been told that this is the most finely run, best tournament you will ever play in your life. It was the most comfortable, the most relaxed setting for baseball. And from Dan all the way down, it's one heck of a nice guy, and he sure knows how to pick a great staff. I certainly don't know all their names, but Dan did a great job, I gotta tell you.
The staff that I have, that assist me with doing this are some of the finest people in the country. They're young, they're energetic, they love sports, and somewhere along the line I've convinced them that kids are number one.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. We'll be right back. unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
And I take my hat off to those of you in Lakeville and Burnsville and the surrounding areas for not only putting good baseball teams on the field, but by bringing the best baseball players to your town. It was an absolute honor and a pleasure to be included in that group, and I'm just saddened by the fact that we won't be able to be there as 13-year-olds next year, because you owe me a gold medal.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.